Welcome back to Close Up. Joe Biden returned to New Hampshire last week with a high-profile speech in which he joined the rest of the Democratic field in calling for President Donald Trump to be impeached. Of course, for Biden, this is an even more complicated issue because he and his son were the targets of the president's conduct. Here to discuss that, another First in the Nation news is WMUR political reporter John DeStaso. Thanks for being here, John.
Thank you for asking.
So this sounds like a real high-stakes moment for Joe Biden because all of these Democratic voters, one of the key questions they ask is, how are you going to hold up when Donald Trump sets his sights on you and opens fire, almost like the Death Star, right? Trump locks on, he reduces these politicians to nothing. Right. So this is it for Joe Biden. He's got to stand up here.
Right. Well, this has been quite a while coming for Joe Biden. I think, the tipping point was the developments of last week. And it is absolutely important for him to show that he can withstand the Death Star, so to speak, as you put it. This will be the test, because Donald Trump immediately came after him. Joe Biden is sort of a part of this whole thing, of course, because he's the subject of this conversation. So again, it was a while coming. Some of the candidates, Elizabeth Warren was among the first to call for the impeachment. He's now joined many of those top candidates in calling for the impeachment, but for him, as a front runner who is struggling to maintain that status, this is very important for him.
You mentioned Elizabeth Warren, an interesting week that was for her as well. She picks up a key establishment endorsement in Molly Kelly, the 2018 Democratic gubernatorial nominee, and also has a candidate here, Michael Bennett, who makes a centerpiece of his visit attacking her on Medicare for All. How do we sort this out?
Well, I think it's certainly a good, Molly is certainly a good pickup for Elizabeth Warren in terms of, she ran what Democrats feel is a strong race last time against Governor Sununu and has a lot of good credibility and good vibes among the Democrats, so that's good for Elizabeth Warren. And Elizabeth Warren is now, it starts with Michael Bennett. Now that she is in that front-runner position, along with Joe Biden, she is going to be the subject of more attacks, more and more attacks, starting out as kind of soft, but I think we will see them ramp up if that is the approach of candidates like Michael Bennett to try to get into this game. They have to go after the front runner, and so the Medicare for All and the costs, that's the big wrap and the big question about Warren's plans.
It'll be interesting to see how she withstands a bit more turbulence
exactly.
On the campaign trail as well. Bernie Sanders picked up a couple of key progressive endorsements, Rennie Cushing and Mindy Messmer out there on the seacoast, but we now know he actually suffered a heart attack in that medical right. episode. So it's sort of mixed for him. He sort of righted the ship with the campaign, and now there's this uncertainty with
right.
the health.
His campaign was struggling internally for a while, as many people know. The addition of Rennie Cushing and Mindy Messmer, who were on his team last time, coming back to co-chair his campaign is a very big plus, I believe, for Bernie Sanders' campaign in New Hampshire. The question now is, how will the candidate hold up? He has already said he's going to scale back his activities. How, in what way? We have to find out in what way. Voters, it is up to each and every voter, of course, to understand and figure out for themselves what is the effect, how does what has occurred with Bernie Sanders affect their vote and their thinking about whether he can be the president of the United States and should also go into that battle, as we were talking about earlier, against Donald Trump as the nominee. But in terms of New Hampshire campaign, it's certainly a plus for that campaign to pick up Rennie Cushing and Mindy Messmer. Now, will the candidate himself really start to focus on the state of New Hampshire?
All right. John DeStaso, thank you as always for your insight. We
appreciate
it.
Thank you, Adam.